Hello and assalamu alaikum. I hope that all of my students will be doing great. So this is lecture number 6, and in this lecture we will discuss the remaining renewable energy source, that was nuclear energy. So nuclear energy is present in the bonds that hold the nucleus of an atom together. This is also called an atomic energy. The energy released in significant amounts in the process that affects the atomic nuclei. The nucleus is the dense core of atom, and a large amount of energy is released from it when we break it. It is distinct from the other energy phenomena such as ordinary chemical reaction, which only include the reaction between the electrons which are moving in the outermost orbit of the electrons, of outermost shells. In the nuclear reaction, energy is released in the form of heat when these bonds of nucleus are broken via reaction, including fission reaction and fusion reaction. The nuclear power is the use of nuclear reactions that release nuclear energy to generate heat. Most of the frequently used of that produced heat is that it is converted into steam to rotate turbines and produce electricity in nuclear power plant. In most of the nuclear reactor, uranium is widely used as fuel, and much larger energy released when the nuclei combined in fusion reaction, mainly in stars and sun. The major drawback of the use of nuclear energy is that it is not yet commercial, because it is quite difficult to control the reaction. And the other major concern is the environmental drawback. The major environmental concern related to nuclear power is that it creates waste which is radioactive, and is harmful for the environment. The materials can remain radioactive in this waste and are very dangerous to human health, because their half-life is comprised of thousands of years. So this is the basic chart of nuclear fuel cycle. The first step is uranium mining or any other radioactive material mining that will be used for nuclear reactions or nuclear power generation. In mining, uranium or other material is extracted from the ground and earth crust, and then it is given for the milling process. Milling is a series of mechanical and chemical process, which process the extracted material, that is uranium ore, and produces dry powder from material consisting of uranium. This is basically the crushing process. The next is the conversion process. The powder, which was obtained by milling and basically crushing the material, is now converted, and the conversion process basically consists of removing of impurities. The impurities are removed using very strong acids, which include hydrofluoric acid, which is one of the strongest acids present on earth. Then comes the enrichment process. Basically, the uranium has three isotopes defined upon its atomic weight. They are uranium 234, 235 and 238 isotopes. The uranium enrichment process is the process that is necessary to create effective nuclear fuel, that is uranium 235. The next next stage is the fuel fabrication. Nuclear fuel fabrication is the process whereby uranium product from the enrichment process is converted into a usable form, that are basically uranium oxides. Uranium oxides are then processed in nuclear reactors to produce electricity, and then this is the back cycle of the main nuclear fuel cycle, in which this is the interim storage and here is the final this is the spent fuel. The spent fuel is basically recycled to extract the traces of uranium, which are fed back to the enrichment process, and plutonium, which is fed back in the fabrication process, and these are the final dispositions. So now we will go in detail of nuclear cycle milling and their definitions. So first, extract uranium from the ore and produce uranium oxide concentrate. Ore is crushed to ground to find slurry or powder, which is then leached in sulfuric acid and other strong alkaline solutions to separate uranium from waste rock. Recovered from the solution and precipitated as uranium oxide concentrate, 200 tons are required to keep 1000 megawatt of electricity plant in operation for 1 year. After drying by using the heat, packed in 200 liter drum as a concentrate referred as yellow cake. Remaining ore contains most of the radioactive materials and rocks. Now let's see the details of the nuclear fuel cycle conversion and enrichment process. Additional processing is required before the uranium enriched oxide is fed to the reactor. 0.7% of natural uranium being fissile must be increased to 3.5 to 5%. Conversion plants convert this oxide U3O8 into uranium dioxide UO2 for plants which do not require enriched uranium. Rest is sent for enrichment after conversion into uranium hexafluoride. Physical process to concentrate one isotope in fuel over others is called enrichment, and enrichment requires uranium to be in gaseous form. U3O8 converted into uranium hexafluoride gas at relatively low temperature, and uranium hexafluoride is separated into two gaseous streams. One is enriched to required level, known as low enriched uranium, and the other is progressively depleted in U235 and called tails or depleted uranium. Then the lower enriched uranium is converted into enriched uranium dioxide so that it can be used effectively in nuclear reactor. In fuel fabrication, enriched and non-enriched uranium dioxide is converted into pellets and encased into metal tubes, which are known as fuel rods. Now, let's discuss about the reprocessing. The used fuel contains about 96% of its original uranium. Fissile U235 content is reduced to less than 1%. 3% of the fuel are waste products, while the remaining 1% is plutonium. Plutonium is then converted into uranium and again fed to enrichment process, and uranium-235 is produced. Pre-processing separates uranium and plutonium from waste products by chopping up fuel rods and dissolving them in acid. The acids which are used are hydrofluoric acid and sulfuric acid. They are basically very strong acids. Uranium recovered from reprocessing contains higher concentration of U-235 than found in nature and can be reused after conversion and enrichment.